Hi, my name is Lisa Balsero with USF Health. Thank you so much for joining us today. This month is Thyroid Awareness Month, and I'm here with Dr. Padhya. Dr. Padhya with USF Health is our head and neck surgeon and ENT physician. Thanks for being here.
Thank you.
So, Dr. Padhya, tell us about the thyroid. Why is it so important to us?
In essence, it's the gland that makes a hormone equated to gasoline for your engine. Too much gas, you're going to rev up. Too little gas, you're going to conk out. So we want it in a nice balance, and majority of the time it is. But when it's not working well, then you start to have symptoms related to that.
Okay, and what would be the symptoms that things aren't working correctly?
If you have too little, you'll feel fatigued, have sleep problems, dry hair, dry nails. If you're overactive, you'd have weight loss, feel jittery, kind of anxious, really can't sleep. So kind of they're both opposite symptoms.
And what are some things I could do to proactively keep in balance in my thyroid, keep it healthy?
Well, number one is just diet. I mean, in the US, we get iodine in our salt and our breads. And so being iodine deficient is not that much of a problem, but just paying attention to eating healthy, just like anything else. So that's first step. Second step is just know your family history. A lot of thyroid problems run in families. So if your mother, aunt, uncle, you know, just ask them. And so that kind of tells you whether you need to be a little bit more vigilant about your thyroid health.
Sure. And so you're visiting your primary care physician. Would you ask for a certain type of test?
Yeah, I mean, it's a simple blood test. It tells us how the thyroid works. And you know, you don't need it frequently, but I recommend, you know, every so often with your primary care, just to keep an eye on it, because it's a very slow process. And so the blood test is just a good screening tool.
Gotcha. And then if you had a more serious condition, would there be different symptoms that perhaps are unnoticed or?
No, as the thyroid stops working or works overtime, those symptoms get worse as the process gets worse. So you'll start feeling it, but again, it's easy to diagnose with a lot of times simple blood test.
Okay. We hear about Graves' disease. It's connected to your thyroid problems. Could you tell us about that?
That's the definition of overactive thyroid. So it's working too much, so you're going to have the jitteriness, the weight loss, dry eyes, sleep issues. So again, a lot of times that can run in families, and also, again, easily diagnosed with blood tests and the physical exam.
Okay. Are things different between men and women as far as symptoms go?
Yeah, not really. I mean, the symptoms are, you know, if you look at a list of what hypothyroidism and hyperthyroidism, there's probably 25 symptoms. So not every patient gets all of them. Some can get these five and some can get another five, but they have a lot in common. But it's just a matter of patient having that discussion with their doctor.
Okay. And then where do you see this field going in the next 5 to 10 years? What are you more excited about, maybe on the treatment side?
Well, I think just people are more aware of thyroid, and same thing with primary care physicians. They just know, so they're checking thyroid blood tests, asking about thyroid, so they're really looking at it. On the side that I do, I deal with thyroid cancer, people are much more aware of it, so we're looking at it, we're finding it sooner, and so unfortunately it's one of the highest, fastest growing cancers in America, but on the flip side, it has a very good survival and prognosis, over 97% cure rate, even if you do have a diagnosis of thyroid cancer.
Excellent. Well, thank you so much for your time today, Dr. Padhya.
Thank you.